Hey guys, how y'all doing? I'm here to give you guys a recap on the new episode of One Piece, which is on episode 816. This episode right here was actually pretty cool, not too bad. However, there was one scene that I kind of asked way too much for, and it was painful to watch, honestly. I'm like, oh my gosh, what I asked for was pretty painful. So if anything else, let's go. We have to it that after the opening, which is always I enjoy listening to, is that we have to it that Chopper, Carrot, along with that Choo Choo guy and with Brulee, apparently Carrot and Chopper are trying to find the mirror to Big Mom's castle. However, with Brulee out of commission and Carrot trying to wake her up, it's very difficult for them to find even which mirror to go to, because all the mirrors are connected to that dimension what they're in all of Big Mom's island. So aside from that, we get to a scene where Luffy is literally trying to rip his arms off. This is the scene that I've been waiting for, honestly, because I wanted to see what the voice acting does for it, and it actually did a nice job. But what makes it more painful is that the ripping sounds and the blood squirting out just made it like, oh my gosh, dude, I cannot even imagine the pain receptors acting on its own to tell Luffy, you gotta stop, you gotta stop, you gotta stop, you know? Ugh. And we have to, that Nami's like, stop it, Luffy, you're gonna rip your arms off. And Luffy's like, that's the point. I'm trying to rip my arms off to get out of here. While we sit here and do nothing, we're gonna get killed. While Luffy ends up messing up and ends up being back to square one, we see a scene with like a Reiju being injured and Pudding going after Reiju, realizing that she's in danger. And of course we see Brook going up against Big Mom, of course, and listens to her and gets ready to fight her and says, I have a mission to do and I'm here to take your poneglyph. And of course Big Mom's like, oh, you got some serious guts right there, kid. And she ends up summoning Zeus and Prometheus to her aid to take on Brook. And we have to it that it goes to a scene with like with Pedro up against Tamago, Baron Tamago. And eventually we have to it that they fight, when they fought each other, it seems like they seem to be on par, like equal to equal. But back then, it plays a backstory where Zeppo and Pedro infiltrated Big Mom's territory and tried to steal some poneglyphs. But apparently that did not work out so well because there were guards and they were distracted by Tamago. Of course, Pedro with his electricity and his sword, he managed to damage Tamago and take out his left eye. But however, before he could do any damage further, Big Mom shows up and gives them punishment. Of course, it switches back and forth about Pedro's past, of course. We had to it that Pedro and Zeppo had a big price to pay. And eventually, it came to a part where Big Mom tells him, you gotta pay up a price now. For you to take Tamago's eye and try to steal my poneglyphs, you have to pay up. And she ends up making Zeppo roll the roulette, which apparently rolls on the 100-year mark, which she ends up taking 30 years from Zeppo, apparently, and Pedro has to pay the rest with 70 years. And we have to it that Peckham's, who was in a great relationship in terms of brotherhood to Pedro and Zeppo, tries to beg Big Mom to spare Pedro, at least. Although, like Big Mom says, I'm willing to deduct it down to 60 years because he just took Tamago's eye. I can't allow that to happen. That is something that can't be forgiven. Pedro, on the other hand, in the backstory, takes out his left eye and gives it to Big Mom and says, will this do? Like, a new dawn of an era is about to come. I can't die here. And therefore, Big Mom says, okay, I'll drop it down to 50 years. Go ahead and live whatever life you have left. You hear me? And therefore, it goes into the fight with Pedro and Tamago. And of course, Tamago did corner him at a wall and pushed him to a point where he's unable to possibly fight anymore. Tamago reminds Pedro, like, you came here in a nightmarish result. You came here, invaded, and tried to steal something in Big Mom's territory, and the result was a nightmare for you. You lost your left eye, you lost 50 years of your life, and your partner. Why do you come back here right now, huh? And Pedro explains to Tamago that the Straw Hat saved my country and my people. I have a debt to pay. I have a debt that I owe them to. And we have to it that Pedro, on the other hand, clashing against Baron Tamago one more time, he manages to break his sword and cuts him in half. While Tamago ends up breaking up into like an egg-like structure, like he gets broken up and sliced like an egg because there's yolk coming out of there, etc. You guys get the point. And therefore, Pedro says, I'm not going to die here. That's it. And preview next episode. 100% guaranteed, those who are anime onlys, you're going to be freaking shocked as hell of what's going to happen. Guarantee. I'll be honest with you right now. As a manga reader, I was shocked very greatly. So if anything else, I'll see you guys in the next recap of One Piece. Until then, I'm out. I'm Alpha Zero, people. Have a good day. And I'll see you guys next time, all right? Peace out. Bye-bye. Toot-toot-toot!